You know, I was very much afraid that you're going to take that admonition of Dr. Murphy seriously, but I'm very glad that you didn't when he told you not to make any noise after the broadcast went on. I'm happy to be with you today. It's a pleasure to talk to the young people who run the school papers of this great country of ours. You probably don't know it, but I was a school editor myself once of a high school paper in Independence, Missouri, and it was a first edition, too. Charlie Ross and four or five other kids and myself got out the first number of The Gleam, named after that admonition in Tennyson's poem, "After it, follow it, follow the gleam." I've been trying to follow it ever since. From then on, I kept going, and you know the trouble that I'm in today. So you see, if you're not very careful, you may end up by living in the White House, and I'll say to you that it's a wonderful experience indeed, in spite of all its troubles. All my life, I've been interested in the presidency and the way presidents are chosen. I remember very well the first presidential nominating convention that I attended. It was in Kansas City, Missouri, in 1900, when Bryan was nominated the second time for the Democratic nomination for the presidency. I was 16, and I enjoyed that convention very much because I thought old man Bryan was the greatest orator of the time, and I still think so. President Roosevelt said he was one of the great progressives of all time, but he was ahead of his time, and a lot of us are in that condition.